All right, welcome back, guys. Okay, in front of me, 3 Poco and 1 LG V50. 5G, see? 5G. Blinking 5G. Very nice. These two, Poco X series and Poco F3. Maybe someday I will get the Poco F5 7 Plus Gen 2. This is a Poco X3, Poco X3 NFC, and this one is a Pro. Actually, the size, the display, the LCD are the same except the motherboard. So I will skip the NFC on this video. Only these three: Snapdragon 855, 855 Plus or 860, and X65 Plus or 870, 870, 860, 855. Adreno 650, 640, 640. All right. We'll be testing Resident Evil 5. Before that, let me show you the device info. That's 5.5, and this one, Poco X3 Pro, 8 GB of RAM, 6 GB, and Poco F3 8 GB, Snapdragon X60. Virtual RAM 6 GB. Meh, get out of there. Right, Poco F3, you already know. Let's begin. Alright, in terms of display, the LG B50, the best display compared to the Poco X3 Pro. The Poco X3 are IPS LCD, and this one is a P-OLED 2K display. And also, the setting are all the same. After this, I show the setting for these two. I'm using Tunip 4 link in the description. Which one better, 855 or 855 Plus?
can't let Irving get away.
That's 6-0 loading
time.
We have to get to the station. FPS F SD 855. At 6-0. More or less, but this one at 5-5 LGB50 because the GPU overclock up to 835 megahertz. This one 573 megahertz, I think. All right, we start with the Poco X3 Pro. SPFs drop a bit.
Come on.
Okay.
You pick that.
Take it.
Roger.
Take it.
Come on.
Okay.
You grab it.
Roger.
You grab it. Everest 30.
You grab it.
Okay.
Where's the team? The team already died. Up there. Well. In terms of color reproduction, IPS compared to the P-OLED. this one better. 2K display, the color more natural. This is the accurate color for this game compared to the Poco X3 Pro. How about Poco F3? Too bright, the sky.
We can't let Irving get away. We have to get to the station.
FPS F3 at 60. Both of these are 30 average 30, half of this Poco F3. These two more or less, except this one. Very bright. This one the sharpest image. LGD 50. Poco F3, this one is 120 Hz. Also, Poco X3 Pro 120 Hz. See the scaling line. But the color, I really like the LG B50. Temperature Poco F3 only 39, almost 40. 39. This one should be hotter because overclock. 42 44 45 46. Still okay. Poco F3 45 43 44 45. This one stable 45, no problem. And this Poco X3 Pro, no fan at the back. And this LG D50, there is a fan. Even with the fan. Wait. Alright, let's see. LG D50. What happened to my controller? Really drops 20 plus FPS. Hey, get away from there. Be careful with it. With the bomb. Dump again. Dump. Big dump. Poco X3 Pro. The color. Still, I like the LG B50. Still lagging up for you. Really drop. There you go. That's the dog. Come on, doggy. Come out. Oh no! Oh no! Okay, not bad. 20 plus really drops. Yeah. See the color. LG B50 and the sharpness of the display. LG B50 FPS. This one better. 2 or 3 FPS. More stable compared to this Poco X3 Pro. Wait, maybe next month the bootloader will be unlocked and let's see what can I do with it. So the setting, for Poco X3 Pro, use the 615 driver. 615. And LG B50. So far this game very stable. Now post cross, seldom post cross, but sometime it just happened. but not all the time, like the TOTK Kingdom. That one almost every minute crash. Bandicoot, this one I'm not using any driver because I'm using Turnip. Same as this Poco F3. Poco F3 60 FPS all the way. Not a problem. Alright, that's it. Thank you for watching. Maybe next I will do the this one, the update, what happened to the game. Actually this game you can't finish it using the emulator. There's somewhere on the shrine that the function not really functioning. Someday I will show you. And thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the next video.